I'm today's now first to speak with English. And, I would like to thank you everyone for coming to hear me. My name is Shin Dong-hyuk. I sincerely appreciate you inviting me here. I was born in a political prison camp located in Waedong Town, Gaecheon City, Pyongan Province in North Korea on November 19, 1982. I don't actually know why I was born in a political prison camp. As far as I know, my father and mother were put in the prison camp when they were still quite young. During my 24 years of living in the prison camp, I never bothered to ask why I had been born there, or why I would have to live there until I died. As a child, the only thing that I knew about my situation was what I was told by a prison camp guard. He said, you were supposed to be killed, but the law has saved you instead. Those you all have to work hard to pay for the mercy the law has shown you. You must pay off all of the sins that your ancestors and family members committed until the day you die. That was all I knew about why I was in there. We prisoners would eat only what they fed us well, only what they provided us, and do only what they told us to do. There was nothing we could do on our own. What the prison camp guards taught us was how to read and write, how to add and subtract numbers, and how to work in the camp. There were immediate punishments imposed even when we made only minor mistake. Those punishments included beating, being deprived of food, or even public executions. Now, I will tell you a story. When I was 7 years old, the guards lined up all of the children in the camp and searched our bodies. They did so to find anything that we, the prisoners, were not supposed to possess. At that moment, a guard found a few grains of wheat on a little girl who was same age as me. As soon as the guard found it, he started beating the little girl mercilessly. The laws and regulations of the prison camp explicitly stated that no prisoners could hide or eat any unauthorized food. They also stated that if a prisoner ate food without permission, he or she would be publicly executed. For this regulation, the little girl had made a serious mistake. The guard brutally beat this little girl. Eventually, she lost consciousness. After that, we never saw her again. That little girl was beaten to death, but the guard didn't have to take the responsibility for her death. She was a prisoner, and to them, she was even worse than an animal. No one could do anything for her while she was beaten to death. We could only stand and watch because there was nothing we could do. Ladies and gentlemen, at this very moment, children in North Korean prison camps are being beaten and killed. Now I would like to ask you a question. What can you do for those poor children who live no better than animals and are dying in prison camps? During my 24 years of life in prison camp, all I saw were guards that were in guards' uniforms with guns and prisoners that were in prisoners' uniforms. There we were not supposed to see what we wanted to see, and we were not supposed to wanted to say. Inside the camp, there is no way that you can know anything of the outside world. Hope doesn't exist in prison camps. There, prisoners watch each other. They even report their own parents' transgressions to the camp guards. If you don't, you will be punished even more severely for staying silent. When I was 14 years old, my mother and brother attempted to escape the prison camp, and I reported it. Then I had to watch their public execution. I was seated in the front row. I watched them being killed, but could feel nothing. In the prison camp, I never knew how parents care for their children and how children care for their parents. I never learned it. In prison camps, there is nothing that parents can do for their children. In prison camps, there is nothing that children can do for their parents. This is because parents are prisoners, and I was a prisoner and as well. Many people ask me how such a thing can happen. But my only answer to this question is, yes, this can happen in prison camps. Prisoners in prison camps are considered nothing more than animals. There was nothing I could do for my mother and brother when they were executed right in front of my eyes. All that I could do was watch them die. The eyes of the camp guards at that moment were not humans. I never saw any human emotions from those camp guards. I understand how hard it is for you to believe and imagine all you have heard from me today. However, I had to tell you this. Even at this very moment, there are many people who are suffering and dying in prison camps in North Korea. The only thing I can do for them is to tell you all how painful and miserable life those in prison camps really is. Those terrible stories that you heard from me today describe just a few of many unimaginably horrible things that happen in prison camps in North Korea. The stories that I told today are nothing in comparison to the unbearable things that I actually went through in the prison camp. The only thing that I can do is to share with you my stories and the testimonies of the others suffering in the prison camp. This is all I can do. The key solution to this problem is you. The whole world was very sad to see the corpses of the 6 million Jews who died in Nazi prison camps about 70 years ago. And we thought this horrible tragedy was a thing of the past. Do you really believe that the Nazis' horrendous wrongdoings are a thing of the past? Do you really think those 2 million people that were killed in Cambodia 40 years ago are a thing of the past? Do you think the terrible things that are happening in Sudan in Africa, Kosovo in Eastern Europe, and Syria in Middle East are all things of the past? Unfortunately, they are not. They are current reality. If we don't act now, we will have to cry and feel pain again, just as we did 70 years ago. This can happen to us tomorrow. Or it can happen to us in a year. We don't have much time. There is one thing that North Koreans do well. They die well. They die from public execution. They die from starvation. They die while crossing the border between China and North Korea. They die from human trafficking. All they can do is to die. Is there really no saviors? You here in front of me, please be our saviors. Please don't just see their pain with your eyes. Feel it with your heart. You are the only hope for them. Thank you very much for listening to my story. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.